소환의 대상 자기라고 크로스 시작하세요.
What are you praying for? How's it going, Julie?
What? Hi. It's a beautiful hotel room. Really? Bed? Table? What else do you need?
Thank you. taping is about as big as that bag, and the camera's bigger than that.
Is it?
It weighs about 10.
They pounds. Are getting smaller, aren't they? Then I'm very, very much more efficient. You're filming, you're not filming that close up, can't
you? Can see a red light?
I can see a red light, yeah.
Let's go, love.
Jack Brabham, here we come. Before we go, right?
Just leave on this road.
Did a better job then too. Everyone wave.
Cheers everybody down there in the middle of your winter. Just to prove that we do have sunshine.
Look, there's ice in the coast.
What is that?
It looks a lot smaller than it was before. It looks as though it needs to be restrung, like tighten
it up a bit, yeah. I've done it before. No, it just needs a new one, doesn't it?
Really?
It's all right
if you turn the camera at an angle. Looks perfect.
You're not videoing the yucky side of the garden, are you?
No.
Go, love.
We could go all round past Checkers.
I don't know if you're going to be in there, but
not
coming out.
Fantastic.
John.
How are you?
That is lovely to see you. How are you looking?
Good, very well. Mm. It's really good. Yeah, but I didn't
fall back. Thank you, Julie.
It's a plastic bag holder. You know those plastic bags you don't know what to do with?
Yes.
Put them in the tub
and
hang it up.
Yes.
And then you get them one at a time at the bottom so they don't get all tangled.
Yes,
no. I use mine all the time. They're brilliant.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I love the material. That's really nice.
Yeah.
There's little tea towels. Mm-hmm. Really?
Yes, I just made them up into the day.
So now I'm going to go down to Cornwall or Devon, maybe, and then to Portsmouth and Rider-Waite and do that. So.
How's it going, love?
Good.
Huh?
Great. Brilliant.
Where are you going?
How are you?
I'm
are you all right?
You.
Nice to see you. Hello, little lady. How are you? What's your name? Yeah.
What?
Don't
work. What?
Don't
work. What? Take your glasses off, I can't see your eyes.
Where was that?
Dortmund's Park, I think.
Oh, there.
This is us being videoed, watching a video. How's it going, love?
About 10 times. How's it going, love? I have to say, good.
How you going, love?
Good.
Peepo!
Sometimes it just goes black, that thing, and you don't know what's going on.
Stop it!
Give
us a whistle.
Thanks. Bangers.
What was that?
Spare ribs, chicken wings, and bangers.
Well, see you all dressed in best white, which is just mixed as well with a nice black of the oil and coal dust.
Front
of the commentary box and you'll be sorted out, and then Ashley will bring the blowing engine into the arena shortly for a little demonstration for reaching an engine across the ring. All very controlled, very careful and very sensible. Is that the best you can do, Bob? It sounds a bit anemic. Oh, that's better.
We're finished with it now.
Is Woodcote. That's a fortnight today. Woodcote near Reading. And that's another excellent... Excellent do. This now is a two-day event. It used to be just a one-day. It's now on for the Saturday and Sunday. Well done, ladies. Don't bring your laundry bill back to us.
See, what happens when one or two go, you get a few of them, then all of a sudden...
there.
You're kidding. I just didn't know whether to start on that.
Why don't you come back and you can be out early?
I thought the
final webs
come from up the north.
Turn that camera off.
There we go. It's great. What's the surface is made of? Granite?
Yep.
Is that easy to take care of or does it scratch?
No, it's hard. Hard. Hard as granite.
Hard as rock.
Hard as rock, yeah.
Oh, really? Got anything to say to Australia, Nan?
And
you're on film.
Am I?
Mmm.
Oh. Angie looks as though she's got fat.
Don't say that on film. She's got smoking, didn't
yes,
she?
Yes, she did.
Was she very thin, wasn't
yes,
she?
Yes, she has, actually. But she's
this lovely cat. Lovely chickens on it.
I hate this.
Oh, well. Are you allowed to move?
Oh, yes! You froze! Would you come in the garden with it?
Yeah.
It used to be around there, so.
Oh, yeah. He says breaking his neck.
Oh, isn't it pretty?
And I say, I let it overflow. Oh, there's a frog in there.
Yeah.
And he's actually sort of. There's one
oh,
over
I
there,
can see him.
And there's one sitting on the side there. Can you see him by the.
I've lost him there.
Like, except as you told me, mine's in lavatories.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a green tree frog.
That's right.
It's so funny.
Well, actually, you see, I went to top it up this morning, and I forgot, just the phone rang. And it went over. It's not usually as high as this. Said you'd take one back to your mum. Oh, there's a bigger one down there. You can't eat them all, you see.
No.
You get them, and then you're just giving them all. They're nice to put whole in a salad, aren't they?
Yeah.
They're nice to munch on while you're in the garden too.
Yeah. We've actually just got two allotments as well where we grow vegetables.
Oh.
Right.
Oh, Mum was talking about that the other day.
Marvellous,
oh,
isn't it?
Beautiful.
And all those pans.
Gone dead quiet.
I know.
Yeah.
Is it sound on there?
Yeah.
Hello. This is us having lunch.
Good, wasn't it?
Take a film of me pouring my coffee in the saucer.
Yeah, all right, there you go. How's it going, love?
This was my beneath. Stop it.
Don't stop.
Stop filming.
Is it going to explode or something?
No.
Don't think so.
No, the novelty is that it's huge.
Of course it
is.
I can't even bite it. I should film John if I was you, Jim.
What, trying to bite that?
Go on, just film John.
Do you? Happy birthday to
yum,
you.
Yum. You've got to blow it out.
Happy birthday
dear
to
John.
Johnny boy.
Happy birthday to you.
Hey! Don't go overboard, eh?
Looks great.
Just have a little slither before
dinner. Are we
going out
to tea?
Yeah.
Oh, the pie's hot.
Is that good, Dave?
Mmm. Excellent.
Is that good, Julie?
Right, you'd like to tambourine while I do the walk round.
Thank you.
Yep.
And yours?
Yep.
Right, the door should be closed and locked.
Yeah,
locked. Right, instruments. Okay, the only two, three we're worried about is this one. That's the airspeed indicator. Tells how fast we're going through.
Golf Charlie Lima, continue taxiing to holding point for runway 25.
Keep going, that's very entertaining.
This is where you go, oh, it's not switched
on. No, you're imagining it.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night. Press the red button.
I'm not going to make you look silly again.
Yes, you are. I'm going to throw this at you. I'm going to throw this at you. And I'm going to throw this at you. Now you can stop it.
Well, we didn't bring any money, so we've had to pay for our drinks the hard way tonight, I'm afraid. Oh, what more?
Oh, gosh. I think that's it. Oh, no. Get the video camera out as well.
Have you ever seen my nanny's? We'll leave that.
Rip that one too. You don't want the paper, so rip it. Good.
There's a switch on the side.
Yeah. Probably deteriorate.
Don't shoot me.
Other way. Looks pretty.
Very well functioning 1911.
midfield. Canberra, Alzita, and moving up in front of those two now, Marielina. Also midfield, those every chance. Just over a quarter of a mile to go, and Brandstorff being ridden out of time and re-challenged Bondade. After those two, bronze runner, very promising, and quite up to their time. After them, Romagan, Billy Martin, still making ground towards the 5-5. Like I say, come on now, down towards the closing game, 6.5 miles so on.
What is it, Dave?
Bloody cartels, man. You watch that.
Is if you got these guys doing their hand signals and you put some classical music on it, like they were conducting an orchestra. Have you got anything to say to the people in Australia, Kevin?
It's very nice to have you in my house.
Oh, in love. Well, I couldn't hear that. Your thumb was out of picture.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Well, you shouldn't ask people how they're going when they're just about to hit a roundabout. It's a bit dangerous.
What? In the summertime. And the living's easy.
I'll
do that.
I'll have to show you the before pictures and then you can see what it looks like.
She talked pretty much.
Smiling on the camera.
I can't be bitchy about my sister-in-law.
You have to be careful what
you say. Oh no, John, you can't. You're totally threatening. Don't.
Now, what are you cooking, Rocco?
No, 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 I can't. Oh, please take it later. Brian, have you seen what they've got here?
What's a fish? It's so warm here. Oh, God. July is just the heat wave.
In a London accent, though.
Oh, look, we're having a heat wave here.
We're going to have a barbie, but we changed our mind. Hey, buddy.
We're going to have a Tia Maria and pork chop barbie.
Yeah, sure.
Shit, I'm darling, so Marlene,
hot.
Bruce,
I can't
coming.
Stand the heat.
And what are we all eating?
Pasta.
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 Well, it's rather a nice sort of pasta in a light cream sauce.
Then,
I've got myself. Go on.
I don't know.
Right, there's this teacher and three girls at a school on the first day of term. The teacher says to the first one, what's your name, love? She says, my name is Petal. So how did you get your name?
Salad's very nice, by the way.
I got my name because when I was in her mum's tummy, she was under a rose bush and this petal fell down from the sky and landed on her tummy. She said, if I have a daughter, I'll call her after this petal. That's why I'm called Petal. She said, oh, that's a good one. So that's good. She said, what's your name, love? He said, my name's Gotham. So he said, why are you called Blossom? Well, because when I was in mum's tummy, she was under an apple tree and this blossom fell off from the sky and landed on her tummy and she called me Blossom. He said, oh, that's really sweet. He said, third girl, what's your surname? What's your name? She said, Breeze Blocks!
Breeze Blocks!
Oprah Winfrey goes for a physical at the doctor's. And she goes in and he says, right, can you strip naked and come back from behind the screen? She gets a bit odd, I normally keep my underwear on. So she strips naked and she comes back to see the doctor and sits down. He says, right, can you get on all fours and go there by the curtains? She's there naked on all fours by the curtains. She says, that's really obvious, that's normally happened. She says, right, can you move in about 4 feet? She moves in about 4 feet on all fours.
And he said, right, can you go over there by the plant a bit? So she's working on all four. And in the end, she's had enough. So she says, what's all this about then? And he said, well, I'm having a black leather sofa delivered this afternoon. I just don't know where to wander. Farmer. Have you heard this one?
No.
This is Farmer. Works up in the morning, right? Walks out into his paddock and finds all his cows frozen solid.
Have you heard this one?
They're all frozen. They're frozen into, like, down there, sort of turn their heads. And eating bits of grass, they're just like frozen solid. So he thinks, what am I going to do about this now? Because it's my livelihood, it's my whole life, it's in my cows. Just at that time, this car drives past, this lady in the car, stops the car, she gets out of the car, looks what happens, doctor, this is Farmer, I can help you. So she goes around the paddock and she touches the cow's shoulders and they come to life. And she disappears every single cow like that and saves their life. They all run off into the garden, grazing grass
and eating their plants.
And the farmer says, thank you, madam, for helping me with my cows. How can I help you? Can I write your cheque? I'll give you some sort of compensation for your trouble. She said, can I write your cheque? He said, what's your name? Thora Hurt. Now, Thora Hurt, someone wants to know his name. Thora Hurt.
Thora Hurt, yeah.
Oh, you're not going to get that in Australia, do you?
The joke, Rocker, the joke.
The joke. Thank you. She's in New York. She said,
my joke? You're
going
to
Rome? Yeah. She's at New York Airport. She's going to Rome to see the Pope. I want to say she's quite apt. I'm sure you can get your mum and dad to listen to this. And it's quite long. And so she's in the departure lounge, ready to board the flight to Rome from New York. And she gets on these future telling weighing scales. Futures, they tell your future. And future scales. And
there's scales, there.
Oh, it's a fortune telling machine. Oh. Are you going to tell it or am I going to tell it?
I'm wondering.
Well, you keep your cake up shut. And she's, I can't look straight to the camera, okay. And, I can't do this, it's so off putting in the camera. Anyway, so she gets out and says, and the machine says, she puts her dime in and it says, you're a nun and you're on your way to Rome to see the Pope. She's like, oh, I don't believe it. So she puts another, excuse me, why isn't the camera on me? And she puts another dime in. She puts another dime in. And she oh, Brian, this is really unfair. You've told your joke. What about my joke? I'm sorry. I didn't take your airtime earlier on, did I? Right, okay. So she gets back on the weighing scales and it says...
The weighing scale?
The fortune-telling scales. It says you're a nun and you're going to New York. You're going to Rome to see the and you're about to be rogered by a big black man who's going to come up to you in a minute and give you the biggest rogering of your life.
That's the bit.
And so... Oh, I can't tell this.
Come on, we're in suspense.
So she gets off the fortune-telling machine and this man comes up and takes her from behind. This man comes up and takes her from behind. She's laying there absolutely, exhausted. She's clambered back and she puts a dime in the machine and it says, you're a nun, you were on your way... to see the Pope, and you've just been seen to by a big black man, and you're going to fart. So she gets off the machine and she farts, and she's like, God, I don't believe this happened to me. This machine knows everything that I'm doing. And she gets back onto the machine, and it says, You're a nun, you were on your way to Rome to see the Pope, but with all your fucking and farting about, you've missed your flight.
Put it on Rocco again.
Hey Brian, there's this other one of yours, isn't it? How's it goes like that? What's it?
Oh, yeah.
A bunny.
It's a rabbit and motorbike.
Okay. What's the other one? What about the other one?
Is his friend in the sidecar?
What is it in the sidecar?
Friend.
Hey, what about the four?
What's that?
The four?
What about the four?
What is this?
What's that? It's a jumper and a tumble dryer. And this? It's a pea on a fork. Microwave.
What's that?
It's a bumper car. Mother, I think my plaits are too tight.
Please.
Rivet, my ram set nail, you see, put that in.
All systems go.
We're all going on our summer holiday.
How's it going, Jew? Dear, oh dear, how many cholesterol counts are there in that one? And dear, oh dear, but Julie's being very good today, isn't she? She's being healthier.
Not a problem at all, 10 past 10.
Love.
Thank you.
of wild mountain pine, all around the blooming heather, where cool a seagull, I will build my love tower.
Was it good for you too?
What you got, Dad?
Not a lot.
We do.
Knock knock.
Who's there?
You.
Wonderful.
What?
We can have lunch here on the moss.
What?
You heard. Yes, you did. Yes, you did.
Tell me once more.
We can have lunch.
The dancers and the singers.
Oh yeah,
it was very good.
Mm-hmm. I like all prep.
We sat there in the sunshine and had a couple of pints of Guinness. And
oh, what was it? Good job.
Here we go.
Have we got a pen anywhere?
Why?
Because
quick pint.
Now run towards me and twirl. Not too close. Now do a big twirl.
The idea was to come up here anyway.
Yes.
I can't catch you on film that fast.
Oh, a little gnome sitting on a rock. No, it must be a leprechaun. What's your name, little leprechaun?
No.
You silly
thing! Anywhere you went, it was like that.
Oh, silly!
Hey Mickey! Hey Mickey!
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 Oh Mickey! M-I-C-K-Y-M-O-U-S-E.
Not getting away with that without showing yours, mate. That's it.
Film's pristine, pretty clear.
Yeah. look at the legs, mate.
Now, where do we want to go then? We've got the Fry Model Railway, Dublinson.
What is this here?
This card in the seat pocket in front of you. Please look at it now.
Julie?
In the event of an emergency, the general emergency alarm signal will be sounded. That is, seven or more short blasts, followed by one long blast on the craft's whistle, and followed by a similar signal on the alarm bells. When you hear this signal, you should return to your seat and remain seated until further instructions are given by the captain or cabin staff. You'll be instructed to put on the life jacket, which is under your seat. Children's life jackets will be provided by the cabin staff. In the unlikely event of having to abandon the craft, when given the order by the captain, you should remain calm and follow the instructions of the cabin staff, who'll guide you to the survival craft. Thank you for your attention.
Oh, what a beauty! Wow! Oops.
What have you trodden on?
It's a can.
It's just a can.
Nice and cold and dry.
And this is the fish that Ron caught.
Happy birthday, James!
A percentage of American students, a buildings of the Great Hall, and beyond that the spire of the City Cathedral, Cardinal's College, by Cardinal Wolsey. Somebody to enclose it, ceremonies, and a student with matriculation, and once when they which is when dignitaries recite to the...
escape routes from this vessel.
Well, the Wellingwood building with a red roof there. House in the battle off the North Cape. Where will HMS Jacobson? Will I dread into the mud? The man who caused all...
Zes uur, vier minuut, 50 seconden. Dat is echt de halve ons van de seconde.
Oh, you can't put it down a little low wall. And then from here, like, drop on the tank. There is still just kind of having that slope. And I'll take a picture. Where are you, Julie? Where?
Greenwich.
One more time.
Oh, look at them. Your garden?
Yeah. Are these geraniums?
Yeah.
Mum gave me a bush my birthday, and she gave me some gladiolas. They're all right along that wall over there. But the little white bush one, I lost.
This is winter.
You put these all in the sun?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. That's nice, isn't it?
Is it a camcorder or a camera?
Camcorder. Yeah.
They're very popular, aren't they?
Yeah, they're great.
Maybe the wife was a yard.
Yeah.
And the crosses.
In the American price list, that was £300 then.
Really?
Ice blue, they call that colour.
That's rare, isn't it?
And they used to put that on the table.
Yeah.
With a pack of cards on it.
Oh.
In, you know, years when it was.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Cheers, Ivy.
Oh.
Do it with a gravy bowl. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers. Nice to see you.
You've got to show Betty this, because this was white. And I had to paint it to match. Is Gussie on the bog?
I think so. Let's go in and see.
No. Oh, this is a toilet.
Yeah, we have those at home too.
But we do sit in here in the winter. Fire that heats all the water. Should be open. The radiators. Kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
Ah.
That's just trying to hide.
Gussie's getting shy. Look, ask Betty if she remembers a plate like that.
Betty,
do you remember this plate? Mum used to have one.
Have a look.
And I found it in a car boot sale. It's not the same plate, of course. Into the
conservatory. Vote for 822002.
Very into hibiscus and busy lizzies. Lumbago, grows in Australia.
I'm number one from the star lizards. I can't give you anything but my love. They're all from the summer of... Number three.
Can I talk?
Yeah, probably. Hang on. Where is it? Point to it.
Can you see it? And forget me nots?
Yeah, we can see those.
You have to get close.
the moth here in Bross, Pops. Can you see me?
Yeah, I can see you.
The moth,
yeah.
Some things the same as you have in Australia. My bike. They've got to see my bike. My bike. I've tried to spray it with a different colour, but every can of paint I picked up in the garage, there wasn't enough of. So I put it in here and just. This is what she's got to get. It does switch on, but it's probably not plugged in. If I can show. Right. See? Right. Can you magnify? Well, look. If she's copying a picture and she wants to see small. Betty, if you're copying a picture. Right. Look. Look. Now look. Brilliant. It is. Yeah. These are books. Of dried flowers for pictures. I haven't done much, but I've been trying to paint, but can't get in the mood for it. I tried that one, and I tried Australia.
Oh yeah.
One of these, that one in Australia when we were at camping. But I didn't get the colour of the sea right. This has been in use. See? Ta-da! This is the table. Bottle stand and a thing.
Oh, yeah.
These are all the posh houses at the back. We're some sort of eyesore to them, showing the rusty old things and everything, you know.
Cue?
I painted mine in yoghurt to try and make it go green, but it didn't work.
Milk. Paint it in milk.
Milk, and it'll go green.
But it's got to be wet all the time.
Oh, well, that's no good. If it's wet all the time, it'll go green. My baby pond, that is going to stand in that pond next year and work. But I need the cable. Ah, I built this.
Did you?
One of my own fair hands with Gus looking for his old man. I got the wood from Ride Demolition for the ceiling in the lounge.
Oh, yeah.
And it was so bad. I said, that is awful. I said, I'm not paying you. And they went back, and then I phoned them up and told them to come and get it because it wasn't what I wanted. And I'm going all dark now. And he said, well, why did you take it off the lorry? I said, well, I thought some of it might be of some use. So after 2 months of not collecting it, I decided to use it. I said, right, you've got 2 days to pick that wood up, otherwise I'm throwing it away.
Well done.
Away, up there.
Yeah.
See, now I never said that. See, she's got it right, hasn't she? Yeah. Hello, everyone in Australia!
Have you got any more sausages, Gus?
Yeah. Do you want some, John?
No, I don't. Are you singing along in here?
I've got.
No way. Do
you know what you can do?
Being primed, yeah.
Something in Australia, guys.
What's it?
Move my lips, she said.
Didn't I?
Move my lips.
It's not you, no.
Didn't I? That's what I said, didn't I? Didn't I, John?
What did you say? I haven't got a bloody clue what you said.
Hey, he was against the wall in there.
He's on for the first solo, I think.
Now, what are you cooking? What are these silver things you're cooking, Gus?
Now, these are...
Those shrimps there, Gus.
Vegetarian carrots.
This is Floyd on barbecue.
They're good for you.
Floyd in these cows.
Especially if you eat them.
Well, I'm not having them if they're stuffed.
But they've got garlic in them. Where's Julie now? Have you left us someone else, have you?
Sorry?
Where's Julie now?
Oh, I don't know. She's in there singing or something, aren't they?
Thank you. my mouth.
Great together.
Do you remember when we were down on Castle Point? Oh yeah. Oh, baby, come on.
Daniel, come here.
We're going the wrong way!
Get out of that way!
Come on, then.
Oh, look, I've already gone. Get in there.
Get in there.
Oh, no, they can't actually get through.
I can't. Come on. Look, we're not running. We're running. That way!
That way!
Yeah.
These are the raptors.
These were the ones on Jurassic Park where the two of them came in the kitchen.
In the Sunday.
My head fall.
It was awful.
Mm-mm.
Pathetic.
Be farther than that.
Snakes and ladders.
Mm. Oh, you were lucky.
Just one snake. You only need one snake. I'm going to come with you, please.
I'm
going
to have to hold this because
I'm watching.
Hold that.
I've been down
there. Shit!
I went down the slide.
Oh, I'm strong.
That's
on the middle, isn't it?
That's a line ball. Do it
Thank
again.
You.
Oh, John.
It's a snake.
Oh, you jammy devil.
Oh, I've got a
letter.
What are you doing?
All right.
Oh, it's down.
A ladder.
A ladder.
Chinese and the dog, but don't take it personally. You are your partner for your start time, should be a cancel your prices. Is he?
There he is. Oh, the
Welcome to Mission Control.
Hello, Julie.
Ready,
Sunday. What is this one? Come in this one. You won't get in with me.
Thank you.
Come on.
But they're well worth it. So, British, any...
Right now, just take the brake off for right now. Don't you do that. Don't you put it on the hill. She's thinking about it. She knows she's not going to do that. She's going to do it every single time. Everybody around the edge gets a free souvenir. Stupid, you're sick.
In the dairy, came to the top was a poor roll. If cheese was needed, it was made there. The curds went into the butter worker and the last one. This is the great kitchen of the Victorian.
Are they good, Gus?
I haven't tasted them all yet, John. I'll tell you when I've gone through the lot.
Yeah, I think we could live with that, yeah.
But Willie told me this joke. He said, a guy went to confession, and he confessed a few minor sins, and eventually he got to the major one, and he said he had sex with a cat.
I told you.
So the priest got a bit upset about this, and he said, look, don't ever do that again. That is a terrible thing to do. No more of that, and for your penance, say three Our Fathers and three Hail Marys. About a fortnight later, he was in the box again, and lo and behold, the fellow comes in, tells a few fairly minor sins, and out comes the big one again. He's had a cat away again. The priest had a fit, and really had a go at him, and said to say the rosary for your penance. Fortnight later, the same thing again. And the priest was really upset with him, so he said, don't ever come back in here again. And tell me that I never do that again. That is an awful thing to do. You go straight to hell for that. Get out of here and don't ever do any such thing again. Forget the cat. Don't touch him. And say two rosaries for your penance. But that night when the priest went home, the old housekeeper was out and he had a glass of whiskey and he sat by the fire. And after a while, he began to feel a bit frisky himself. He was thinking over the story, and there was a parish cat. Sitting on the rug. So he thought to himself, well, I wonder. So he grabs the cat and he tried one or two strokes, and all of a sudden the cat went berserk and scratched the head of him, lacerated his hands and his nails and his face and really tore him to shreds. So he gave up at that. Fortnight later he's hearing confessions again, and suddenly the guy's in the box. And he says, a few minor sins, and straight away here it comes again. he's been at the cat again. The priest is about to break into a terrible rage and suddenly calmed down. Hang on. Listen, he says, tell me something. Exactly how do you go about that? Doesn't the cat sort of scratch you or anything? No, he says, I get a pair of big, thick leather gauntlets, he says, and I strap them on, a few pads on my knees, and I really pad up, he says, and then I grab the cat. I see, says the priest. Right, he says, well, for your penance, he says, try it without the gloves.
How's it going then?
We did it's lovely. It was a lovely day. This is an English barbecue.
Yeah. We're all miserable.
Yeah. The sun is shining and the rain is not raining. And the Australians are winning at the cricket, so we're very happy.
I said that the cook's outside of the shop.
Get his off.
You're allowed to talk.
You won't get me all inside, huh?
They are.
It's about the best way to meet, isn't it?
You're smiling, Brian.
Cheers.
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 Yeah, cheers.
Good on this board.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
Yep, yeah, we got you there.
Hello.
Hello.
Between January, February, March and April then. 3 hours.
Does that work, John?
Yeah, I can see you.
Honestly.
No problem.
Same as well.
Dad, yeah.
What about a special message to
say something. Special Betty. Message to Betty and Ken.
Love you both. Cheers.
Have you got a good day for the day?
Have you
got
a good day? Say to you both. Many happy days and thank you for Christmas last year.
Yeah.
This year. Is that right, do you think?
No, it's last year.
This
when you come
no.
Over?
Oh, no, it's
last year.
When you're coming over, sport? That's what I want to know.
All right, yeah.
How about our holiday on the horseback? The
Ken's in there.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
He wants to go on one pub crawl. Yeah.
That's right. Yeah. It's, yeah. He did that. Yeah. That's great. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't really like camels very much. It reminds me of teacher's training, and I didn't like it.
Ah, how you doing, sport? Hey, come on, that's a lovely spot. Yeah.
How do you fix the film, John?
Hiya, guys.
Sorry, I've wasted some of your battery there, John.
The dessert will be the main course.
Right, we're on.
Okay. Does he just give it a little blow in the end?
Alright.
To try and get the wheel to go around.
Okay.
Like so. You have to give it a real good, hard blow. Right?
All I can say, Nick, is...
Can't get it to go. Let's give it another go. It takes a real hard man's blow to get that wheel to go round.
Just go.
Let me have one more go, see if I can get it to go.
Nick, get the wheel mounted.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, it should go. I mean, it's fairly much.
Brian, the wheel needs to go fast. The pipe can't be lined up with
it's
it.
It's not quite going. Oh, I don't think I've got enough
blow. It used to go fast.
Here we go. Oh, my gosh. Give it a hit.
Yeah.
You're going to try again, John. You're going to try
again, mate. Out of
curiosity. You've got a blowing hard enough, mate.
Yeah, right. He's looking for all the old things. Let's have a go. Where do you want me to hold it? Let's have a go.
No, not that one.
John's got a white eyelash too.
So we go. Oh, it went then. See it go slightly.
Oh yeah, I figured it out.
No, okay.
I was trying to blow through my nose and not my mouth.
It's run out.
Maybe you got it.
How do you do it?
Oh dear.
That's brilliant.
Oh my god.
Do you got to get a bit of a blow to get it to get around?
How can you get that wheel to go around?
I'm trying, but I can't get it
around.
There's a hole there, it's just a bit.
It's not blocked up, is it? Okay.
There.
Real hard blow, Brian.
Very good hard blow. My God, look at my new trousers. Look at my new trousers. What about some of this carpet? Oh my God.
So we go.
Can't get the wheel going.
Do
macro on Brian's ear holes because they're full
of powder. Oh, I'm blooming going. You're going for
sure.
The side.
It's good
though,
isn't it?
It's
really good.
Yeah, it's true. Brian, if you close your eyes, it doesn't come out.
Why?
Because they look silly with handbags.
Oh.
It's so funny, I'm going. going to die. Hello, Charlotte.
And little Sam.
And Samantha.
Yes, right, yes.
And Samantha.
Did you get my letter?
Did you get my letter? I gave it to Judy. She should have gave it to you.
She hasn't got it yet.
It's still here.
It is.
This is what it looks like.
Why don't you read it?
Yeah, read it out. Yeah. Oh.
It's talkies, so you can. It's walkie talkies, so you can move, yeah. Yeah, oh, that's beautiful. So what is it? What model?
So a Heritage Softail.
Right, okay. Heritage Softail. Yeah. Very good.
Yeah, and I had a new cam put in it.
Yeah?
And I got all...
Oh dear, it's going to see the fish.
Yeah.
My boat doesn't fall over. I'm just about sick of cooking. My position is closed.
This is
the creases, very creasy.
Charlotte and Gilbert.
Are you turning it up? Charlotte's Ellen Creasy met her husband, Gilbert. No, she was Charlotte Ellen Knight, I beg your pardon. She met Gilbert Creasy. He was working for the man of the house as a gentleman's valet, and my grandmother was a parlour maid.
Oh.
And he got her pregnant, and so they got married. And she had the first child, which was John, and then David was born. That's David's father.
Mm.
And then her husband was killed.
How was he killed?
He was trampled to death at a football match. He collapsed drunk at a football match.
Oh, wow.
And he was trampled on. And so in those days, it was there were no pensions, and it was the grandfather's job or place to look after any grandchildren. And so she had to go and live with the children's grandfather, who happened to be a tailor. And she was given a room in the top of the house.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Because he took care of her and her two boys, she had to do all the housework and the cooking and the cleaning.
Mm.
And the boys had to make buttons because the tailoring business was carried on in the house.
Oh, yeah.
I can't think of anything else to say to him. I could make it up. Hang tight. And one day, one of the sisters, she shelled a colander full of peas.
Yeah.
And what happened? The old grandfather used to pay her a very meagre salary for doing this housework, but she never opened the waste bag. She used to give it straight to his wife. Then he called her into his room one day and he said, "Charlotte, I thought you might have thanked me for your rise in pay." She said, "I didn't." She called him Dad. She said, "Dad, I didn't know I had a rise. I give my pay packet straight to Mum."
Uh-huh.
And he was so furious, he went to sort out his wife, and she was cross that she'd been split on.
and there was Gran. She shelled a whole colander full of peas, and she met her at the top of the stairs and tossed the peas up. The peas went everywhere.
Oh, no.
That's the sort of thing she did.
Oh,
dear. And
so when she was giving her pay packet to her mother, was it?
It was her mother-in-law.
Her mother-in-law.
Unopened.
Ah, okay.
You see? And so then what happened? She managed to get another job outside. As well as doing the work in the house, she got herself another job and saved enough money to rent a flat in the same road.
Yeah.
And she moved out with the boys. But it was a struggle.
And that's when she had the typewriter and...
Well, that was when John was older.
Yeah.
And she carried it. Big typewriter. She carried it on this. Get it repaired because he was sick all the time. And he died when he was 17, so he was a poorly boy.
Yeah.
And it's probably because he wasn't fed properly.
Mm.
And they lived with the grandfather.
Well, she used to give him his crust of bread, didn't she?
Oh, yes, she used to bring home food from wherever she worked. They often used to be stuffed things over. And that's why my dad was never very good at sport, because when all the other boys were out playing in the street, you know, football like boys do, my dad had to stay in and make buttons for the... They used to make their own buttons. He was making buttons and doing all these tailoring jobs and clearing up the workroom.
Yeah.
He wasn't allowed to play out with the other boys. So he was never any good at sport. He used to like watching it. He was never good at playing it because he'd never had any practice.
Yeah.
Had a terrible childhood, my dad.
And he's very thin, wasn't he, because of it?
Yeah.
And he didn't marry Nan because they were looking after Charlotte.
Well, that wasn't the reason, actually. They were engaged for 7 years. And Mum said, oh, when are we going to get married? And he said, well, I've got my mother. And she said, well, your mother would live a long time. So he said, well, would you mind if she lived with us? And they got on famously.
Mm.
So my gran always lived with us. And it worked. It worked well.
That's good.
Actually, Mum got on better with gran than Dad. He was more critical.
And better than her own mother.
And better than, and there was this awful jealousy between the two grandmothers, you see, because my father's mother lived with us. Her mother used to get jealous.
Oh,
yeah.
I don't, you don't know about these things when you're a child.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
We've been waiting for you to come down to ask him. I said, considering you asked my oldest dad, you say he's older than me, younger than me, he's 2 months younger than Fred.
Oh, that's good.
Coming back.
Hitchhiking, right? And this car stopped to give her a lift. And it was a very elegant woman, it was a big Rolls Royce car, very posh. And she sat, oh, it wasn't a woman, it was a nun, that's right, it was a nun who got stuck and she was hitchhiking. And she got picked up by this woman in this car. And as they were driving along, she said, you know, this is a really nice car. And she said, yeah, I was given it. And then there was silence again, and then she was up. She said, oh, you know, it's a lovely fur jacket you're wearing, you know, your rings, your jewellery, you know, the way you're dressed. You're obviously very well off. She said, no. She said, oh, this has all been given to me, this has all been presents. So she said, well, you know, how come? She said, well, because I'm a prostitute, she said. So the nun looked at her and she said, you mean you've got all this from being a prostitute? This is all presents from being a prostitute? She said, yeah. So the nun was thoughtful for a minute, and then she looked up and she said, to hell with Father Riley and his bar of chocolate.
Done it?
Yeah.
Cheerio, Mum.
you got a pedal on it, right?
No, this is what.
So they're saves, aren't they?
Eh?
The red ones are saves.
The red ones are saves, yeah.
Cecil Bill B. De Creasy.
Oh, he's not waving, we'll have to come back and go again. Oh, there we go.
Big wave!